gon' make them too. I can't fall asleep, I gotta stand tall, that's what a leader do. Follow me, I'm leading you. Hey, we finna turn up, crank up the heat in here, they finna burn up. Told them I'm coming, I'm here, tell them they turn
up. Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
All right, the stage is set for what should be a really good game one as this series gets underway. Introductions wrapping up down on the field and first pitch just minutes away. And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. It's game one of the American League Championship Series. It's the Los Angeles Angels taking on the Cleveland Guardians. With my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Chauvin. Game one is always critical in a postseason series, Singy.
Yeah, and this is when you love having home field advantage, Boog. If you capture game one, you're full of confidence that you've got a chance to ride that momentum for the rest of the series.
And on the visiting side, starting pitching is always the big key in a game like this to kick off a series.
Yeah, you need a strong performance on the mound. That's the number one way to cancel out the home field edge we just mentioned.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Go ahead, run on base. And now here is Max Stassi. He's 0-for-1. Swing and a miss, and that is strike one.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Going to count 1-2. This one blasted deep to left. Way out of here. Home run. He made him pay for that one, and they add a pair. It's 2-0.
With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient and waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Here's David Fletcher. And that one is lifted in the air. Fletcher retired. And there's one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Ward, batting with one down, takes a strike. And that is in for a strike. 0-2. Shane Bieber, former fourth round pick out of UC Santa Barbara. He's won a Cy Young Award, the pitching triple crown, and became the first pitcher in Cleveland history to win a gold glove. Not bad.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised by that last one, being the first one to win a gold glove with the great pitchers that they've had over time in Cleveland.
Trout in the box now. No balls and a strike. That just misses. And 1-1. At 30 years old, Mike Trout, 1,000 runs, 300 homers, 200 stolen bases. The only other players in Major League history with those numbers at that age, A-Rod and Willie Mays. On the ground to short, Rosario. On the run, sends it over to first. And that's the third out. Two-run shot for the Angels this inning. It's now a 2-0 ball game. This is the American League Championship Series on the show. I'm on now. I'm dropping the top. I'm skirting off. I'm in a foreign now. Magic City, bring an umbrella. It's pouring down. Heist box for the drip drop. Spend 300 for the flip. Back now at Progressive Field. Bottom of the inning. Stepping up for the Guardians. Mike Zunino. The pitch. And that skips in the dirt.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Here comes a pitch. Singing Shohei Ohtani has been as advertised. Rookie of the Year in 18, MVP in 21. He has impacted the game in a major way. And then, of course, he was on the cover of MLB The Show in 2022.
Well, he's doing something that we've never seen done before, and just absolutely phenomenal that he can be that dominant on the mound and be one of the top hitters in the game. And just watching that, it's got to take your breath away a little bit if you're a manager or a teammate to see this actually happening before your eyes.
Strong. Now at the plate as he swings through strike one. Ground ball right side. Rendon throw to first. And that quickly two away.
Up next for Cleveland.
And up next for Cleveland, Stephen Kwan. Look out! And it hit him.
Well, it looks like he wanted that slider to finish on the inside part of the plate, not start on the inside and end up hitting the batter. It looked to me like he just tried to do a little too much with that one.
Rosario stands in now and watches strike one. And a foul ball. That MVP I mentioned about Ohtani in 2021, he was actually a unanimous MVP and the first unanimous AL MVP. Got him looking. Fastball at the letters froze him for strike three. One left for the Guardians, and they're down 2-0. Top of inning number seven. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. Bieber back to work. Ball one low. Next offering is in for a strike. Just off the inside edge. Strike two.
Well, and those hitters count sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
Next offering misses, and it's 3-2. And the pitch. Good job to fight that one off. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Renfro in the box again, takes a strike. That's in there, and that is strike two. And downstairs, Ohtani gets his lead at first, nobody out. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
That's a pretty nasty pitch right there. I'd call it a power curveball in the 80s. It's got so much spin on it, and you really don't have a lot of time to sit back and watch what it's going to do before you have to commit. It was a good one for the swinging strikeout.
Walsh up to the plate for the third time as he looks at one down low.
Last two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, you're going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at bat.
Swings and misses, struck him out. Gior Shela to the plate. Hot shot to first base, and he snags it to end the inning. Angels leave one, but they're on top 2-0. Bottom of the seventh, now it's Jose Ramirez. And a pitch. Ripped on a line to center. Trout pulls it down, and a quick out number one. And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell. First pitch, and he just misses. Action in the Angels bullpen. Ryan Tepera getting loose out there. Loop, the lefty, warming up as well. The 1-0. That one the other way. This looks like extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. And he's in with a stand-up double.
He was all over that one. Just a really nice approach to shoot that line drive to the opposite field. There's a lot of hard work and discipline that goes into getting a result like that at the plate. Doesn't come naturally for most hitters.
And here is C.J. Krohn. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
1-0.
That's to third. Diving, and he can't make the play. Stop sign goes up at third. Runners at the corners with one out.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. He wasn't able to elevate it, but he put a great swing on it. Right on time, good balanced approach, and just blasted it through the infield.
One down. Andrés Giménez digs in for the Guardians. One for two. Pitch misses inside. Ball one.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
He swings and fouls one off.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
That's towards center. Trout settles under it. Brings it in. Runner tagging from third. The tag gets him, and it's a double play to end the inning.
Always exciting to see a play at the plate, trying to score with two outs, but the tag just gets him in time, and they cut down the run to end the inning.
Ready to begin the eighth. Here's the
Second baseman, Anthony Rendon.
Daniel De Los Santos gets the ball now.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep him within striking distance.
Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2. And there's a ball.
It's a good take.
The 1-2.
Ball two. 2-2.
On the ground at first, and he grabs it foul. Next pitch is downstairs.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Max Stassi comes up to hit. He's already homered here in this one. First offering misses the mark. De Los Santos, 27 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. Next offering is in for a strike.
Where do you even begin with the talent we've seen from the Dominican Republic? Vladdy, Big Papi, Pedro, the list goes on and on.
The pitch. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Here's a 1-2. Stassi started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first. No swing. He held up. Carl Dixon with the call there. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. battling here as he fouls it away. Next offering is fouled back.
Now he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. That's his second strikeout. And the batter now, David Fletcher. And first offering is fouled off. And the right-hander deals.
Ball, no.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And that just misses. Got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
And welcome back. Now here is Oscar Gonzalez.
The right fielder.
And a pitch. In for a strike. 1-1. Activity in the bullpen for the Angels. Jimmy Hergett, the closer, is getting loose. Strike two.
Just an outstanding job of spinning the baseball, moving it around, doing what he does.
Here's the 0-2. Upstairs. That one down the line, and that's a fair ball. Here's Mike Zunino. The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. Swing and a miss. Throw. Save. Chris, his wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with StatCast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number. I mean, man. He really made his athleticism work for him on that one.
Terry Francona bringing a bat off the bench. Josh Naylor, big spot for him here. The tying run at the plate. Popped in the air, left field. Ward hauls it in, and there's one away. Oh, he throws it away. Now it's going to be Miles. Now a move being made for a pinch hitter, George Valera. He gets a chance with a runner in scoring position and one gone. And that's in there for strike one. Gonzalez over at second, one down. That one lifted to left. Ward sizing it up. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there are two outs. Back to the top of the lineup. So in now for Cleveland, Stephen Kwan. Swing and a miss. Slider right there.
Tonight, his slider has been really impressive. I mean, tight spin. Seems like the hitters aren't picking it up out of the hand.
Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now.
Man, that's just a nasty splitter. Bottom falls out of it. You don't see a lot of guys throw that these days, but I tell you what, he's got a good one.
The pitch. Down and in, moved his feet. To the right side, Walsh. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one left. We're on to the ninth in game one. Angel. So remaining in the game defensively, George Valera. He'll be out center now after pinch hitting.
Number 76.
Also into the ball game, Bo Naylor. He takes over behind. The play. So out of the pen comes the right-hander, James Karinchak.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
A swing and a miss, and that's strike one.
It's had a tough day at the plate, three strikeouts already. It's hard not to think negative, but you got to find a way to somehow center up the baseball and put it in play.
And the righty deals. Fouls it off, still 1-2. And now 2-2.
Two ball, two strikes.
Got him swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. And now batting, Mike Trout. That catches the outside corner. Strike one.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for guys to square that up. That's what you love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Right-hander kicks, deals. Foul ball, it stays nothing and two. Hit, connect on the curveball, struck him out.
Well, I'd say he pretty much had to offer it that one. You don't want to leave it in the umpire's hands. Even though it ended up outside the zone, it still was close enough to where it looked like it could drop down right on that corner and get the call. Last thing you want to do is get punched out by the umpire knowing you could have.
They go with the intentional walk, so he's on first with two out. Hunter Renfro at the plate. Just missed. Now 1-1.
They just threw that fastball by him, elevated, and if you're not looking up in that location, very difficult to catch up to, especially with that velocity.
The 1-2. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. He swung over top of the curveball. Bottom of the ninth coming up, and we'll see if he can complete the shutout after the break. Bottom nine, here's the shortstop at the plate, Ahmed Rosario. Well, it's pretty clear that he was frustrated, and even he admitted as much with his performance in their last series, but now a chance to hit the reset button.
That's one of the things he's going to have to get used to, being the superstar player in this lineup. They are going to pitch you very tough, and you make the adjustment, you can have success. I think you'll have it in this one.
Swings and misses, and the count even at one. Out to short, Fletcher. On to first, and the leadoff man retired here in the ninth. Now here's Jose Ramirez. Swing and a foul straight back. The next pitch misses, and the count is 1-1.
Well, just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
Oh. One down, base is empty. Now with the shift on, hits right into it. Sends it to Walsh. Out. And Ramirez is set down. Now, two outs, base is empty. Here's Josh Bell.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
That one missed.
1-0.
Swing and a miss. And it's 1-1.
From a pitcher's perspective, that's a beautiful splitter right there. As a hitter, you don't like it. But he's commanded his fastball, and out of that same tunnel, that splitter comes, and the bottom just falls out of it.
He's got it. Ball game. And the Angels get a shutout on the mound.
It has become increasingly difficult to throw a complete game shutout because of all of the offensive prowess that these hitters are showing around the league today. But he had total command of this game, and he saw it all the way through to the end. Nice win.
Here's another look at the numbers from this shutout victory.
Well, it takes a team effort to produce a shutout. I mean, sometimes you just got to tip your cap.
So the Los Angeles Angels dropped their first game of the postseason here in Game 1. So maybe a little bit of a gut check for them to begin the LCS.
Yeah, I think that's the right way to put it. I mean, they've showed they're going to be a major threat this October, but after a loss here today, we're going to see how they respond, and it should be very interesting in Game 2.
Welcome. Thanks for joining us. We've got the American League Championship Series on the show. It's the Los Angeles Angels taking on the Cleveland Guardians. So two down, Hunter Renfroe, the next to hit for the Angels.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit is probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
Check swing went around, and the count 1-1. Ohtani at second with two down. The 1-1 is fouled off. That one misses, and it's 2-2. Swing and a miss, and that is that.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there, and sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the sixth inning. The left fielder, Stephen Kwan. The wind of the pitch. That one finds the zone. Strike one. All right, Singy, trivia time. Back when this ballpark opened, 1994, one future Hall of Famer hit the first triple in the park, and another hit the first homer by a Cleveland player. Think you know who they were?
Okay, I know that Ken Griffey Jr. hit the first triple here, but first homer for Cleveland. Give me a hint.
Switch hitter. That's all you're getting.
Oh, dude. Eddie Murray, no doubt.
Bam. Anderson ready to work. Way high. That's off the mark. And now it's 3-2.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Next offering is fouled back. The pitch. And he grounds one to the right side. The throw to first. One up, one down. And now it's Ahmed Rosario. Ball one there. Right side, Rendon. Over to first. Two up, two down. Now it's Jose Ramirez. The switch hitter batting right. Swing and a foul straight back. Well, Jose Ramirez had a sensational 2018 season. He became just the eighth player ever to have a season with 30 doubles, 30 homers, 30 steals, and walking more than he struck out. Next offering is downstairs. Two down, nobody on. Just misses with that one.
It's a good take.
Line drive, and that's a base hit to right. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. And he's in there standing up with a two-out double.
He went up there and got it with two strikes. I'm not going to leave this in the umpire's hands. I'm going to be aggressive. It was in a location where he could get those arms extended that he loves to do. So nice job right there coming back in that at bat.
Josh Bell at the plate now. First offering, and it just misses.
And the strategy of winning a ball game, when you could make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up.
At the belt and fires. And that is cut on and missed. One and two. Action in the Angels bullpen. Jaime Barilla up and throwing. Two outs. And a ball evens the count. Two outs. And one in scoring position. Next pitch is outside. CJ Krohn would be next if they can extend the inning.
And he's homered already, so I'm sure he'd love a chance to do some more damage here.
3-2 now. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Here comes a 3-2. That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. They're waving Ramirez home. He'll score easily, and they lead by two.
Back-to-back base hits. Anytime you can drive a ball into the gap the other way, it feels so good. And that's when you know you're right where you need to be at the plate. And it's even better when it gets you extra bases. Love looking in at your dugout and seeing the guys fired up.
And here is CJ Krohn. He's already homered in this game. High fly ball lifted in the air right field. And that'll do it. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Back here in Cleveland, new inning getting started. And now the first baseman, Jared Walsh. McKenzie back to work. In the air out to center. And out number one on the grab. Gio Urshela steps in. In there for strike one.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
This one popped up. Jimenez makes the grab for the second out.
I always remember watching Johan Santana pitch, and when he was in his prime, you would see
A lot of guys out in front, right-handers pulling that changeup in the stands and then fouling the fastball the opposite field up into the stands.
Rendon in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. Kicks and deals. Knocks that one away and will do it again.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
Righty delivers. Good eye right there.
Really good slider. He's up there just hoping that it ends up off the plate away.
This one popped up. Foul ground first base side. Jumps at the wall and he brings it back. Offense held in check there. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. Guardians 3 and the Angels 1. Welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And the batter now, Andrés Giménez. And here it comes. Outside. Well, he's back out there to begin the 7th. That surprised you at all, Chris?
Yeah, a little bit. It was a little rough to 6th inning there, but his skipper's got a lot of confidence in him. But trust me, they will keep a close eye on how he does in this one.
Trout makes the catch, and there's one gone. And now the right fielder, Oscar Gonzalez. And that's a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away. Here's Mike Zunino. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. Swings through that one.
Fair ball, one strike.
Line drive. That's a base hit. Lead runner touches second, headed for third. The throw in, not in time. He's safe. Now the Angels manager is out of the dugout, and he'll make a move to the pen. Tyler Anderson is done, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. New pitcher in the game for the Angels, Jaime Barria.
And he's coming in to pitch on 4 days rest right here. And that might not be a factor at all in terms of being rusty, but he should definitely be well rested.
One away, runners at first and third. Miles Straw digs in for the Guardians. And that is in for a strike, going one.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
In the air, out towards left center. Great effort as he's able to haul it in, and there's two down.
Now back, left field.
Now the left fielder, Stephen Kwan. Lined into right. Makes the catch, inning over. Guardians strand a couple, but they still lead it 3-1. And welcome back. We go to the 8th. Max Stassi comes up to hit. McKenzie back to work. That misses the zone. 1-0.
You know, these Angels definitely being aggressive at the plate, but I think it's fair to wonder if they're being a little over-aggressive. One thing that stands out looking over the numbers is the amount of outs they have on the first pitch of the at-bat. They've given away too many at-bats with easy outs.
Here's a 3-0. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Pitch count's getting up there now, and not saying that's the reason for this walk, but this is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
Fletcher in the box now. strike one. The pitch. Fought off foul. The tying run at the plate. Popped up to the left. Into foul ground. And there's one down.
That was a good, hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop-up and an easy out for the defense.
Pitch misses there. One and one.
Now, this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Stassi, the base runner at first with one out. Caught him looking for the K.
Well, just excellent location on that inside fastball. Really locked him up. And as a hitter, it's not typically what you're looking for. You're trying to protect away and then in, so you can be a little bit tardy with two strikes. Hard to tell if he was fooled or if he thought it would be called a ball, but either way, that's a really nice pitch.
0-2 as he waves at that one. Struck him out swinging. Slider got him for strike three. Angels strand one, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. Here in Cleveland, leading off, Ahmed Rosario. Correa, 26 years old, and he was born in Panama. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Walsh makes the grab, one down. Here's Jose Ramirez, 1-for-3. Bounce to the right side. Gathers and throws to first. And Ramirez is set down. And now the switch hitting first baseman. Josh Bell. And takes low for ball one. There's a strike.
Been a solid inning so far in relief. Getting them through this inning only down two could give their lineup a real opportunity to just grind their way back into this game with the few outs that they have left.
The wind of the pitch. On the ground to third. Urshela to first in time. Out number three. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. And the score stays 3-1. Here comes Emmanuel Clase out of the bullpen. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. Here's Shohei Ohtani. This guy has turned into a beast. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average. But there's on-base and slugging, too.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power. But then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw. You know?
Yeah, no question.
Now it's Hunter Renfroe. Runner at first with no outs here. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Flashes the leather on the running catch. And there's one down. Jared Walsh now at the plate. First pitch just misses. Ohtani at first, one gone.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Checks his swing, now an appeal to third. And he punches him out, he went around.
Just indecisive in that at bat. He couldn't commit to the slider, tried to sit in between, just not able to put the bat on the ball.
So it's their last chance in this one. And next for the Angels, Gio Urshela.
And that's in for a strike.
Pitch misses, and it's a ball and a strike.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
Just one strike away. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. And a 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Got him! And that's the ball game. So the Cleveland Guardians pick up a win here in game two to level the series at one game apiece.
Yeah, this thing is turning into the series we expected, Boog. A pair of evenly matched teams going back and forth. I think we're in for a good one.
Seems like we're destined to come back here for at least one more game, and I wouldn't be surprised if we see this series go seven.
Forever is a long time.